Hi, my name is Jeannie Shiffer. I'm the Associate Director for Communications at the United States Census Bureau. Today, I'm going to talk to you about customer relationship management in a digital world. So, customer relationship management, what does that mean? It refers to the practices, strategies, and technologies that organizations use to manage and analyze customer interactions and data across all touch points and throughout the customer lifecycle. CRM systems compile information about each of your customers' preferences and interactions across all of your different channels or touch points. So we're talking about websites, telephone, live chat, direct mail, and marketing materials. Customer relationship management history at the Census Bureau really started in 2010 when the Bureau put in place various customer and partner support systems, including a partnership management contact database. Our goal was to allow the 2,700 partner specialists to manage all 257,000 decennial partner organizations, their contacts, and all 2010 Census commitment activities. We also had a customer service contact center exclusively for decennial, which was different from the other call centers throughout the Bureau. So some of the lessons that we learned and some of the changes in our customers since 2010, I'm just going to touch lightly on that. The customer experience is the sum total of interactions between an organization and a customer over the entire duration of the relationship. So the four quadrants would be survey respondents, data users, employees, and partners. And it's very important to always remember that your employees are an essential customer. To deliver a great customer experience, we needed to display six characteristics. Number one, define a clear, compelling value through journeys. Know the journeys that matter, and I'm talking about customer journeys and why they matter. Continuously innovate the end-to-end customer journey experiences. Number four, use journeys to reinforce the frontline culture. Number five, optimize processes and systems to ensure consistent delivery. And number six, use customer journeys to define metrics and governance. So we needed to identify and analyze the digital and physical touch points of each customer segment's journey. So digital touch points would include things like email, websites, social media sites, and physical touch points would include things like paid advertising, such as radio, TV, print, or direct mail pieces, or call centers. So there are five touch points throughout both the digital and physical customer segment journey. Number one is awareness. Number two is consideration. Number three is purchase. Number four is service. And number five, the all-important loyalty expansion. So we needed a common view of each customer. Different divisions at the Census Bureau each had their own customer and partner systems, resulting in duplication of contacts and uncoordinated communications among those customers. So we needed one single view of the same contact across all touch points. In the U.S., citizens are digital and they're social. Out of the total population of 322.9 million people, 282 million are active internet users, 192 are active social media users, 342.4 million have mobile connections, and 169 million of them are active mobile social users. And the U.S. is increasing in mobile too. 72% of all Americans over 18 own internet-enabled smartphones. 92% of those are between 18 and 34, and 65% of them are 35 years or older. 72.4% of U.S. women versus 70.3% of men own smartphones. And very interestingly, 45% of African Americans and 43% of Hispanics versus 38% of whites use smartphones to find government information. Customers want both self-service and full-service. Customers want to be able to self-serve, download their own content, and update their own events for review and sharing, but they also want full-service. So you have to be able to accommodate both styles of service for your customers. And the solution needs to be able to adapt to the customers. So customers in the U.S. demand a personalized customer experience, whether they're shopping for shoes, for cars, or visiting government agency websites. But only 31% of consumers said that organizations they visit consistently deliver personalized experiences in multiple communication channels. And we need to always try and treat every contact as a potential social media partner. So if we're working with a data user and providing them assistance with using data, we need to remember they're a social media user too, and how can we leverage that contact as well? Delivering a consistent customer experience requires an integrated solution, and there are four components. One, web content management system, or a CMS. Two, a customer relationship management system, or a CRM. Number three, marketing automation and tools. And number four, data sets and tools. Each one of these four components is very valuable, but not nearly as valuable as when all four of them are shared and integrated. And at the Census Bureau, what we have done has taken all of the information from those four components and put them into what we call our customer analytics dashboard so that we can see all of those experiences in one place. The features of an enterprise customer relationship management system. It provides employees across the enterprise with the same 360-degree view of the customer or the citizen or the partner, their actions, preferences, and interactions across all channels. Stakeholder contact management, customer profiles and preferences, citizen or stakeholder case management and workflow, knowledge management and FAQs, reporting and analytics integrated with dashboards. What we plan to do next in 2017, we're working on a mycensus.gov experience for partners, as I talked about with customization earlier. So we want to add the ability for our partners to add their own commitments, events, and content for review, and then share it and publish it. We want to integrate with the content management system and marketing automation. We want to integrate customer and citizen information with a third-party data management platform. And we want to integrate an e-commerce solution for ordering pre-printed promotional items and customize print on demand with business rules in the customer relationship management system of which each partner can order. For example, we can create basic business rules that govern promotional materials, and partners can take those materials and customize them for their own local community. So, for example, if a partner is helping us promote activities surrounding participation in the decennial census, they can customize these materials for their own community. So in late 2017, or perhaps into early 18, we plan to expand mycensus.gov to citizen data users and respondents with a mobile-ready experience and personalization. Thank you very much for watching today. I encourage you to visit census.gov for more information.